Welcome back to my channel. My name is Lauren and I'm a junior nursing major here at Troy University in my second semester of nursing school. This semester I am taking psychiatric mental health nursing, adult health one, and pharmacology. And I have clinical for both adult health and for psych. So I thought that today I would give y'all a few of my tips or suggestions for clinical. So, I know that I was really nervous, like I didn't know what to expect because we didn't have them first semester. And so I think this would be really beneficial just so you have a little bit of an idea of what's going on, what you may need, and maybe how to help this process go a little bit smoother. So let's get started. Okay, my first tip is be prepared. So that's kind of self-explanatory, but like, How do you be prepared? Like, what do you need? So I personally like to pack my lunch the night before. See, I had morning clinicals in Montgomery, so I had to drive an hour away. So I was having to be there at 6:30. So I would leave here about 5. And that way, if I woke up late, I could just grab my lunch and run out the door. So I would pack all the dry stuff. So I'd pack like Cheez-Its, a Cosmic Brownie, and then I would make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich before I went. So I would leave the peanut butter out on the counter so I wasn't like searching if I was in a hurry. So then the next morning, all I had to do was get the jelly and slap it on some bread, and then I was ready to go. Another thing that I like to do is prepare a water because you may get thirsty, you never know. So I would always pour waters into this big water bottle, and then I would bring an extra so at lunchtime I could pour in there if I was really thirsty. Another way that I stay prepared was I loved to lay my clothes out the night before, like physically touch them. I knew they were all clean. They weren't super wrinkly, anything like that. I would lay out undergarments because our clothes were white. I needed to make sure that I had the appropriate colored undergarments, socks, shoes, badge, into any equipment like stethoscope, bandage, scissors, pen light, anything like that. That was also really important so that when I woke up, I knew exactly where everything was. I knew what I had to do. Also, going into that paperwork, I would always sit down and I would go through everything that I knew I would need for the next day. I would make sure that everything was printed out that I needed to turn in, that I had everything printed out that I needed to complete while I was there. And I would paperclip it off into sections, and I knew what was supposed to go where and what it was for. And I think that that helped me a lot, and I put everything in the same order. So we always had a journal due, and we had a rubric for the journal, and we had a rubric for that specific day of the clinical. So I always started with that specific day. So I put that on top, and then I'd put my journal and then rubric. So every time I had something, we had an OR rotation. So we went to the OR, we had a journal due. So it was journal, rubric, and we also had a paper due. So then it was paper, rubric. So having that, you know, set up for me, everything was always organized. It was always in that order. So I knew that I had everything together and I could easily go through and look at that. Okay, so my next one is to be involved. Personally, I wish I would have been a little bit more involved, but I do know that I was always like, hey, like I am in nursing school and I'm still new to all of this. So even if you may think it's something minute, like I'd probably be really excited to get to try it. So if you have any skills, even if you think they may be boring, I would really love to do them. And I really don't mind, just please let me know. And I think that my nurses kind of understood that I wanted to do stuff. So I was able to do like a non-sterile dressing change. So that was really cool that, you know, probably wouldn't have been done had I not been like, hey, I want to do something. Do you have anything I can do? Like, even if it's small. So that's one thing, just being involved, making sure that your nurse doesn't need anything from you, and things like that. That leads me into my next piece of advice is ask questions. If you don't know what they're doing, ask questions. Get as much experience as you can. Just being involved, asking questions, making sure that you understand things. How does this apply to what you're learning in your classes? Ask your clinical instructor things. If you don't know something, look it up. That is probably one of the most difficult things for me is, well, why don't you just tell me? Well, if you have to take the time to look it up, then you're probably gonna remember it. So yeah, I think that it's really important that you also look things up. So be involved, ask questions, look things up. Just constantly let them know you are there, you want to learn, and you want to have a part of that care. Okay, so this one isn't gonna be for everyone, but for me, I like to leave at 5, so I would get up around 3:20-ish, and I would get up, make me some breakfast, just check my phone. I would do my daily coloring picture in my coloring app, and then I could get dressed. I could warm my scrubs up because it was kind of cool, and then I could leave, and if I'd forgotten something, I could turn around and get it, or if I had an accident, then somebody should be coming through so that they could get me if I needed that to happen. So I personally got up way early. I know people in my group wouldn't get up till 4:30, just depending. But for me, a tip would be get up, get ready, be energized, get you something to eat, because you don't know when your clinical instructor is going to be like, all right, it's time to eat. So that was a big thing for me as well. All right, and the last tip that I have for you all today is to do your paperwork when you get home and do it well. Like, you're only going to hurt yourself in the long run. Do the paperwork, do it well. Understand why you're doing it, why this is happening in the body. And, if you have questions, ask. But if you're trying to do it the night before it's due, which ours are, it depends. It could be 3 days later. It could be a week later. If you're trying to do it the night before it's due, chances are you forgot it. But if you do it when it's fresh on your mind, first off, that knocks it out. You don't have anything else to worry about. And second, it helps you create a better, plan of care, if you have care plans or anything like that. And then we have to do journals, like reflecting on what we did. So having a journal right after you, doing your journal right after you leave, when you go back and look at those things, you'll be able to see them and know that, this is what you did. It's more detailed because you're not trying to make something up. Like, it's actually what you did. And you can go back, 30 years from now and look at that. Maybe no one else will. I know I probably will. So, but yes, just do your paperwork, do it well, and do it as soon as you can. All right, you guys, that is all of the advice and tips and tricks that I have for you for clinical. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, go ahead and like this video. And if you want to see more like this, please subscribe to my channel. Comment any ideas that you have or questions that you may have for me, and I'll do my best to answer them. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time.